2022, I'm gonna call a regular city council meeting of the city of Winfield to order. Everybody to please stand, and we will have the pledge of allegiance. First, we have Mr. Miller, will you do our invocation tonight?
Yes, sir. Our dear kind and gracious heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this day that you have given us, Lord. We thank you for the rain that you have sent our way, as you know the need. Lord, we also thank you for the honor and privilege of assembling here this evening to conduct our business. We ask your guidance over these proceedings this evening. Help us to conduct our business in a way that would most benefit our citizens. Lord, we ask your continued blessings on all of our citizens, our city employees, police officers, firefighters. We ask you to keep them safe and out of harm's way. Lord, we ask you for your forgiveness where we fail thee. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Please join me in the pledge of allegiance to the flag of our country. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Are there any amendments to the agenda as was posted? If not, then we will move on. The next item on our agenda is the guest and audience participation. Is there anyone in the audience or any guests that would like to address the council? Okay, not, we'll move on. We have no old business action items. We have no old business non-action items. Under new business action items, the first one is to accept the minutes from our July 11th regular meeting of Winfield City Council.
So moved. Second.
A motion by Demery and a second by Junkin. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Number two is to accept the minutes from the July 17th special meeting of Winfield City Council.
So moved.
Motion by Demery.
Second.
Second by Miller. Then number three is to accept the minutes from the July 21st.
You gonna vote?
No.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Got ahead of us, so motion carries. Number three is to accept the minutes from the July 21st, 2017 special meeting of the Winfield City Council.
Second.
Motion by Mr. Miller, second by Councilman Demery. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Number four is an introduction of an ordinance by Mr. Edwards. Second by discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Okay, number six is authorization for the mayor to renew the service contract to Taylor Power Systems for the well 13 generator. That's the generator we put down there on our water well.
So move.
Motion by Mr. Miller.
Second.
Second by Demery. Any discussion on that one? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Okay, number seven is Wind Parish Hazard Mitigation Plan Resolution. This is from the Wind Parish Administrative Assistant. I got an email saying that the Wind Parish Hazard Mitigation Plan had finally been accepted and granted APA status by FEMA, and that they need each jurisdiction and the parish to formally adopt the plan. And once they get all the resolutions from the various jurisdictions in the parish, then they will be submitted, the final version will be submitted to FEMA, and they will provide the parish jurisdictions with a final hard copy. And so this is a we need to do a motion to, or a resolution to accept the hazard mitigation plan to be permitted to FEMA.
Have anybody seen any draft of it?
It's a long document. I looked through it. I got the email version of it and scanned through it. It was put together by, we had a meeting back in a parish-wide meeting of parish officials back months ago, where they came up and presented what they were putting together. And I think this hazard mitigation plan has to be, once it's accepted by FEMA and in place, that's how we are able to get FEMA funds necessary in the future.
But it is not there.
And then, so.
You have to do like the 911 board or who?
No, this is, you know, based on various scenarios, whether it be a tornado, what could be, could happen here with a tornado, a hurricane, flooding, all those type of things.
Action plan.
Yes, sir. And it's a document that's about that big. And the GOCEP agency from the state, they'll put all that together.
That's one question. Have you heard anything about the flooding and stuff that's over there? Have we got anything back from the state?
We're talking to them. This this plan here, you know, the flooding part, but it doesn't, that won't have any effect. We need to approve this or get it approved, but I've been in touch and in talks with the GOCEP office in Baton Rouge.
So we'll be talking about that as well.
Well, I mean, it's there's a lot of work to be done over there, and it will take a lot of money. So we'll work, you know, in discussion with them on that, you know, the possible funding mechanisms.
So he's just saying we are approve this resolution, and I mean, would the parish have the total say so?
I can read you the resolution.
Information on it.
It says that whereas the parish of Wind recognizes the threat that natural hazards pose to people and property within Wind Parish, whereas the parish of Wind has prepared a multi-hazard mitigation plan, hereby known as Wind Parish Hazard Mitigation Plan Update 2016. In accordance with the Disaster Mitigation Act of 2000, whereas Wind Parish Hazard Mitigation Plan Update 2016 identifies mitigation goals and actions to reduce or eliminate long-term risk to people and property in Wind Parish from the impacts of future hazards and disasters, whereas the adoption of Wind Parish by the Parish of Wind demonstrates their commitment to hazard mitigation and achieving the goals outlined in the Parish Hazard Mitigation Plan Update 2016. Now therefore be it resolved by the Parish of Wind, Louisiana, that Wind Parish Office of Homeland Security and Emergency Preparedness adopts the Wind Parish Hazard Mitigation Plan Update 2016 for the City of Winfield, Wind Parish.
So moved.
Have a motion by Mr. Miller, second by Junkin. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Sarah made the second?
Yes, sir. Number eight, appointment of Mayor Pro Tem for 1718, and for Mayor Pro Tem for 1718, I recommend Sarah Junkin. She has the most free time of anyone on the council, and she also served, agreed to sign on as the council person to help monitor our plan of action with the state auditor. And so that's my recommendation for Mayor Pro Tem. Okay, a motion by Demery, second by Miller. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Now we move to new business, action items, non-action items. And number one is Recreation Department and the Rapids Foundation Grant Update. Mr. Edwards.
Charlie, you have the recommendation, $20,000 for them.
Sure. I've got Preparation Director A.B. Hall here, and I've got Daniel Rocket here, who's president, who is the chairman of the Recreation Board. So y'all come forward. I don't know if you want to ask some questions or let them do some talking first, or...
Mr. Daniel, we were just talking right up today, you know, we were all there at the last meeting, and I was on vacation.
Okay.
Just kind of to tell you sort of what's been going on with the grant. Of course, you know, Mr. Pete Armstrong has been hired by Rapids Foundation, you know, to kind of help guide us as we created the master plan. And several things that he did, he looked at all the survey results, which, you know, went out in like fields. He looked at the community meetings, and there were three of them, one at Pilgrim Rest Baptist Church, the Moss Street Gym, and the Parish Library. And as we were waiting on him to return with those results, some things that we've been doing, we've reviewed some bids for the bathrooms. We've looked at some people, commercial contractors who are willing to do bids on projects like bathrooms and parks. We started planning several community events. One of our events was a basketball camp that we had in July. Stephen Randall did that. He's a partner with the Junior NBA. And if you had a chance to look at last week's paper, we held the art camp was featured on the front page. That was one of the things we had. And then last Saturday, we hosted our first play day at the Grove Street Recreation Center. There were about 40 children from the city and parish who participated in different activities, basketball, art, glitter bike, water slides. One of the big hits was tennis. Miss Jennifer Frederick came out, and she had a tennis pitching machine and tennis rackets. And there were several kids who enjoyed that, who had never had a chance to hold a tennis racket before. We're planning another park day on the 19th at Henderson Park, and we'll have some new activities at that play day. After that, of course, with Mr. Pete's return, we've looked at the recommendations for each park and some of the things that he's emphasized, such as safety and accessibility. He shared those recommendations at a public meeting that was held at the Wind Parish Library. Right now, what our board is doing, we're walking each park and gym and we're looking at the recommendations that he's made and trying to create a map and a master plan, using those recommendations and what space is available, looking at things that, where the greatest need, and we're also looking at some other grants and funding opportunities, because we'd like to see as much done in our parks and recreations as possible. We've also updated our bylaws and elected some new officers, and if there's ever any playground or recreation concern or suggestion, you know, feel free to contact us. Because with your support and the mayor and the citizens of this parish, we think there are some big things that are going to happen in our park and recreation system in the near future.
So what you're saying is that the bids are in? Because y'all seen the bids?
We've seen two bids on bathrooms that were high. And what we're going to try to do is try to get a package put together with bathrooms and some of the other things that we're trying to get done, and hopefully come in saving the city some money so that we can do more things with the grant money. Nobody has canceled the bathrooms.
Is there a start date that you, Mr. Pete, have put on paper?
What we're going to do is we're going to try to have all of what we're doing right now as far as getting the map and getting the scope and sequence together. By the end of this month, hopefully we should have a package put together.
Yeah, and that building down there, that'll be pursuing to everything, because if you understood that, like, we have a meeting, our meeting will be the first Thursday of every month, like that, and probably using the avenue, so that way we'll post it just like how we all meetings, so it's open to the public if they want to come. And pursuant to what the mayor has to do as far as the bid law, we're going to have that together by the end of this month. So if he has to put it out there to keep, and, you know, which I have to do, he can put it out there. Right now, we've talked to, as far as like the floor, Tim Monson, who's from Snapshot Sports, who's going to do the floor, and that's what everything is, Grove Street Gym. And also with some other contracts we've got, we're reaching out and trying to get everything together, to, like, put it together so that way we'll have one plan. As well as like Mr. Pete, when talking to the mayor and when meeting with us, he said that we can go back to the money that we get from the Rapids Foundation and we can get it all. And then Virginia wanted us, what they challenged us to do, they put in priorities as to what we need to do first. And by the survey, what they had was the two most things that need to be done, that was at the top of the list, was Henderson Hall Park and Grove Street Gym.
We don't want the roof? The roof was set.
The whole gym.
Let me ask a question. When you were talking about doing the bids because of the high bids for the restrooms, that you would possibly be able to, maybe the next bid that goes out would involve, they come and do the restrooms and some other stuff, so maybe that would be how the prices might average out a little bit better than being so high just on bathrooms in one month.
Doing one project at a time.
Right, might be too much. So trying to get maybe one contract the bids and does a greater scope of things.
Yes.
Okay, and save the money in that way. Okay.
We kind of set that as a whole, like the bathroom, that's the worst thing that's at Grove Street is the outside bathroom.
Right.
Well, what I'm saying going forward is going to the bathrooms in the gym, everywhere the gym be open and stuff like that, so that whenever we get this together, if we have to, if they're trying to find somebody to come in because the bids are actually real high, I'm going to try to put it out there again, I can see that we can kind of put the bathroom, the remodel of the bathrooms in the Grove Street Gym, we can put the restroom in the floor and stuff, and then come back to the later day.
I guess what I'm asking is the construction of new bathrooms also would be part of that?
Yes.
You know, so
part of that.
Okay, so that
yes.
would be, okay, so that way, if they're doing more one contract, they're doing more, he might charge us less and get more work.
It's a larger,
job for him.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
I charged AB and the rec board with them coming up with, based on what they want to see done and based on the surveys and everything, them put it together. And then I, within the budget of the grant, come back and present to us, hopefully in September, what they recommend that we do. We vote, give them our blessing on it, and then have, and then move forward with a package on it. And but I want them to make, put the plan together, make the decisions, and there's a lot of interest and a lot of energy on the board right now. I've been, they were at Walk, they were at the parks this week, started Monday morning, and we're looking and coming up with what they envisioned for the first start.
Tomorrow, so they decided to walk on the parks.
So the action is really going in September, that's what you shoot for?
Yes, sir, that's what I'm shooting for. Any other questions, or?
I guess if we got to understand on the refuge foundation, I see the regular recreation is on there, so I did have one question, Mr. Hall, on the regular recreation, I mean, okay, now, sometimes you hear rumors, and I don't know if it's true or not sometimes, so I ask, you know, I mean, I know this time of year you start with your flag football program.
Right.
Some parents have asked me about the flag football program, and, but they asked me the way, you know, it'll say they hear that it's not going to exist, and like I say, oh, I say, so I ask you, I mean, you mentioned anybody that it's not going to exist?
No, not at all.
So the program goes forward?
Yeah. We're looking at it to try to, we're looking at the staff to try to curtail it as far as like running it and try to keep, which is the thing that the mayor shouted me on as far as like my people, that like we have games on a week or something like that, I would have to go to the point of adjusting my guys' schedule so it would not be going overtime or something like that. Like they were nothing and say that going forward that we would not have a football program.
I guess the other question I got from the mayor is that in the budget, you know, there's the people that you have on your staff now. So, do we have fun? Do we increase the staff?
Not without amending, looking at amending the budget.
So what is the point of the future?
He has, you can tell him how to do, you got on the staff, you got, go ahead, you got.
With myself, Joe Chapman, Tony Thibodeau, and Dietrich Lee. And the only question I can have, maybe it's something that for the council to look at, even before the mayor became mayor, as far as my thing, I worked in recreation before, so this is set up on before, program pretty much runs itself. Any fee we charge, split down like before when I became maybe recreation director, I worked there before, the question that people, parents had was, where was my money going? So I came up with a resolution and showed them where my money was. If we charged $40, we split it down the middle. Half of it went on the uniforms, which in basketball we had the shirts and the top. The bottom and the top, which you never had before. It was printed on one side, they got to keep it. And they were able to see that, and the other money we went to take care of paying for officials, concession, and everything. I have some stuff, next time we meet, if this question come up, I'll have it, I can present it to you. Because I keep track of it, I turn my money into City Hall and everything else. And I looked up some past stuff that Pat had on the computer to where the way the program is not designed to make a lot of money, but it's supposed to take care of itself. Outside of last year, which I'm all aware of in basketball, we had Phil. And I actually have that paper for y'all too, and I would have to give to each one of y'all. Is that outside of basketball was the only time, to my recollection, that we didn't make our money. It maintained itself, so.
Yeah, I just charged him to, or asked AB to, you know, work up a little budget for it, for flag football, and then, because we want to try to get the program to pay for, you know, break even. That's what we're shooting for. So.
Well, we set it to, in case it doesn't be fun, then we able to, yeah.
We'll have to. Subsidize it if it doesn't. Hopefully it will. And that's why I told him what we got to watch is our overtime. Overtime costs for what can get out of hand real quick if we're not careful. So, but we're moving forward with flag football. Okay.
Thank you, fellas.
Thank y'all. Keep working on it. I'm looking for a plan next week, next month. Yeah. Okay, number two is the electric department update. Mr. Edwards.
Well, yes. That's good, of course, we're
okay. I got our new electric supervisor here, Mr. Ketchum, who worked for the city now for almost 2 weeks, a week and a half, and I got him to come tonight, and Adam, you can stand up and kind of introduce yourself to the council, those that you haven't met, and you can tell a little bit about your background, and then maybe what your plans are, what you see that we can, as far as running the department a little bit.
Sure. Name's Adam Ketchum.
Yes, sir.
How can I shake your hand yet or yours? Very nice to meet y'all. I appreciate y'all giving me the opportunity and everything. In the election department, I've been here a couple weeks. Of course, we know that that's partly time to really get a good broad spectrum of stuff. But I've seen a lot of stuff that we can improve on. There's some line loss issues that are out there with some streetlights that are burning all the time. We're going to get those fixed. Trees need trimming. Anytime you see a limb into the line and it brown leaves there, you've got electricity that's going without getting metered. So there's a lot of line loss issues out there that we can handle. We're going to get. There's transformers that can be taken down offline. Try to bring that line loss down some, which is going to, of course, make the electric department more profitable. I'm implementing meetings every morning with my staff so we can set a goal, a daily goal of stuff that we want to get done for that day. Barring any weather, inclement weather, or outages, we're going to set those goals and tend to those goals daily. We're also implementing kind of a weekly quick 10-15 minute second meeting every week to where we just discuss some hazards that somebody may have seen and I've also asked my men to write down if they're out driving around and they see something needs some attention, a pole that may need checking or anything, and bring it to our attention so we can work that into our goals, daily goals as well to get it fixed. I've got several years background. I'm a second generation lineman. Been around my whole life. I worked, I covered about 100 miles square mile service territory at the company I was working with in Texas. 7 substations under my care, numerous circuits, and maintained most of that by myself for the most part. I also have construction background with electric lines. To be a real lineman, you know, you don't specialize in just one spot, which is service or construction. You kind of get a little bit of everything, and that's what I've done with my career to help build my knowledge of the systems. Is I worked with service truck for 10 years, and I worked construction for a few years to kind of get both sides of it and know how it all works together. And I also had 5 years of meter building meters, checking meters, reprogramming meters, changing out, disconnecting, reconnects, all that stuff. I'm excited about moving forward with this. It's going to be a project, but I'm up for the project. So I'm excited about it and really look forward to moving forward with this.
I guess my question to you is that, to show up here the time you've been here.
Yes, sir.
We didn't have an outage after outage. We had one last night. So.
Right, one last night was
my question to you is this. What have you seen so far? Is it the system that we just put in, the new system, or just our old system that we have out here on the line and stuff like that? You just got to get about there.
Well, that new substation stayed hard. I'm going to tell you, I've been in a lot of substations. I've been in them from so old that you can't really do nothing with them all the way up to new, and this one stayed hard. It's amazing. It's going to carry the load. It's going to do exactly what we need to do. What I've seen as far as outage problems right now is like last night, it was probably just a limb fell through the line and blew a line fuse. So stuff like that, the tree trimming that I had planned, I'm setting 1 day a week aside for tree trimming, where we're not going to do regular service work other than the connects and disconnects, which of course the people need to have. But we're going to get out there and trim these lines, get these driveways back in shape. And the outages from last Friday night?
Yeah.
Okay. That one there was it was an old transformer that, like I said, we're going to be taking some of these old transformers off when we get up there. That was an old transformer that should have been taken off a long time ago, and it was still hot. It caused a mess.
So will you be able to, as you checking all your equipment, be able to see the transformer that maybe need to be replaced? I mean, just from visual?
Absolutely. Visually, on transformers, what you look for is leaking transformers. If you see oil running down the bushings, you can't really tell if they look real, like, old. That don't mean nothing. Just because the, like, the paint's wore off and that, and they still be perfect transformers. But you look for leaking oil. You look for them if they're not certain enough to take them offline. Because if they're not certain enough and they're online, they're still using energy to be having pools heated up. So
when you pull down, the Mac left out, you know, watching you do your job, and it was 3 minutes. And when you went back up, it went back up to 2, but you know, put the third one up there. Is there a reason for not doing it? Is that one of them old?
Yes, that was an old, what they call P&L pot, power and hiding pot system. And there's a bunch of them still online out here. I was actually driving through and got a note back here. I made a list of ones that are not needed no more. The old system of putting power and hot pots up is the deal about that is you have one big pot that conducts, that handles most of the load of power. And then you got a lighting pot, or transformer, we call them pots, I'm sorry. You got a lighting pot that just handles basically small loads, 120 lighting and stuff like that. Well, if the lighting pot's not being used no more, you just take it down, do away with that, and that eliminates future problems like what we had last Friday night.
Tell me about the same thing. Couple nights later.
What happened on that was the arrestor, which you can't visually see it when it happens, that load from the transformer blowing up like that, the initial, I guess, fault current damaged the arrestor on the next pot. And you can't see that visually, it just, when the arrestors go bad, you don't know it until they blow the pieces. And when they blow the pieces, they'll kick the line all the way back out. So, but we also got something implemented where we're going to try to sectionalize that out a little bit better. And I'm looking for places where I can put sectionalized stuff out where we can go and close these in and get the rest of this back hot without killing the whole town.
And the last question to you is how many men you need?
Four or five sufficient. I mean, it just depends on their knowledge and experience.
Yeah, tell them about the work you're going. It's going to happen tomorrow. We got
a heavy duty arm going up across the street from City Hall here. That's going to sectionalize out that line where we had the big problems last Friday night. And it's going to actually have a dead end place where you can open that up and heat the rest of the town up if you need to. If something happens out that way, and we also got a broke pole we can replace tomorrow with the new broke pole. I'm going to go ahead and get it replaced, and it's all going to happen hot, so we're not going to kill the lines out or nothing like that.
So right now you have equipment stuff that you need to go forward?
Yes, sir. The only thing I'm looking at is updating and getting a few safety equipment things that I seem to need. And I'm not trying to spend a whole lot of money. I'm just trying to get some stuff I know that keep our men safe and keep us moving forward with make sure we've got dependable and reliable power at this time.
And my last question for you as well is that the training part of it, is any type of training that's still available for our employees, you know?
Yes, absolutely. LEAP, I believe it is, they conduct schools. They have schools that are week-long schools. At the end of the week, you get a certificate. They have climbing schools, transformer schools, regulator, closure, faster schools, underground schools, basic electricity schools, all the way up to advanced climbing, hot work. They got all these schools that, and I'm the type of person that I've been through all these schools. And I still can go through them again. I like to learn. Every day's a learning day for me. If you come to work, don't feel like you're learning, you need to just go to the house. And any of the men that express that they want to go to these schools or whatever, I'm definitely going to bring it up and see what we do about working out a schedule to be able to send them. That way they can get the training they need.
Adam, we're glad to have you.
Hey, I want to express my thank you to all y'all for allowing me to come here and give me a chance and opportunity to do this.
And
so.
Hope your wife and children enjoy it also. I mean, it's a change for them.
We're in a transition. I'm living here, they're living there, and I'm going home on weekends. And we'll get back into a routine. You know, we're looking for a house here. We're looking to move here full time, and I'm fully ready to be active and involved in the community and do what I can to make sure we
And one of those outages, you understand, were scheduled off and you were home 2 hours away and you did turn around and come back, and thank you for doing that.
That's part of the job, as far as I'm concerned, in my old territory or someplace I had to drive 2 hours for, I didn't start looking at lines. So that's part of the job, and I fully take on that aspect of it.
That won't happen again.
That's right. So anybody else have any questions for me?
Thank you.
Thank you guys so much for your time.
Yes, sir, thank you.
If you need anything, call us.
Y'all need to see.
I need your number. Don't give us your number, that's bad.
Sorry, guys.
Okay, number three is an audit update, Mr. Edwards.
She pointed out a few things to me about the audit, so we got a bit more time to go.
And they'll be here doing their field work next week.
Okay.
For 2 days. And so hopefully that one will be wrapping up after the field work next week. Hopefully it'll be wrapping up the next few weeks.
Kind of get back into it.
Then we'll be, once it's submitted to the auditor, then hopefully we'll be back in compliance. And then, of course, we'll have the year we just finished, 16, 17, stuff there to give them when they finish this to start on this year.
Yes.
Which is not due until December the 31st, or by December 31st.
Well, once we get this out of the way, then we can start looking for a compliance, getting compliance.
Yes, sir, if they, it'll be up to them to grant it, the state auditor's office to grant it. But I have no reason to think that they won't.
You see, that depends on the finding.
Well, the findings and, but we submitted a plan to correct the findings for the last audit, and which they accepted. And so I feel like that same plan will work with this one, you know, going forward, so. Number four is a budget discussion, Mr. Hams.
Well, I'll be kind of brief with this budget discussion, and I want to really address it to the council. Okay, I was asking that Mr. Abner about training, and his answer was sufficient for what I was concerned about, being proactive instead of reactive, and that was a good thing. But was the council aware that there wasn't any revenue placed in training for like electric, recreation, things like that? I mean, I was like, how can we do that without putting any revenue toward things like that? No revenue, zero in this particular fiscal year. And that's something that's very important for all of us. And speaking of training, again, a week or so ago, the council had the opportunity to receive training at the LMA meeting. No councilman went or was able to go, and this was scheduled months ago, and I was wondering, even though the funding was in there, so I was wondering why this didn't happen as far as, who we need to see to say, I'm going to training, I'm going to get my ethics part of it, who we supposed to see? I mean, I thought we just tell them, hey, we want to tell the clerk, hey, we want to go to the meeting, schedule it, and it be done. Is it somebody we need to go see now? That's my question.
The all expenditures have to be approved through the mayor's office.
Okay, well, who's considered as the mayor's office? I mean, what are we?
I am. I'm the one that made that decision.
But it's in the budget. It's in the budget for us to be able to go to training. And I don't feel like you have a right to tell us we can't go get trained.
I didn't stop you from going and
getting trained. Yes, you did.
Well, I went up there for one thing. I paid my own way.
Well, what did you do with that credit card you had?
I didn't use it. I used my own credit
card. Well, turn it in. You don't need that then. If you're stopping us from going to training, you're stopping people. We got city employees that go to training. And they have to wait in line and have to call back because they can't even get in the room because you've got the credit card in your pocket going about your business. That's not acceptable, Mayor. We don't want this place denied training. Not council, not you, not our employees, nobody. So if the reason we not getting trained because of you, that's got to be changed. Herman, we got to put an ordinance in place for that, son, to make sure we go to LMA meetings and things like that, if the money's in the budget?
If you pass one, you can.
Okay, well, that's what maybe we need to do, because he said, if the mayor say he's the reason we can't go, because that's what he's saying, that's not good. We elected officials just like he is. That's not good, so we gonna have to put one in place.
Looking what the training is in there for City Hall.
It's in there.
I didn't think it was a budget item.
It's line item budget for City Hall, they have one in there, travel and training.
It is.
Yeah, it's in there.
Training, meals and travel expense.
Right, and for you to say you made that decision, I mean, that's a problem.
Does anybody else on the city council have a problem with that?
That she wouldn't, that's what I'm saying, if we're not able to go, that's different, we'll say I'm not able to go, and that's sufficient, but if we were able to go, it could be, you don't need for you to say that you paid your way, but you decided we can't go because that's what you decided, that's not good. We the council too now, we sit right here, just like you elected.
Here's, but if I had decided, if I had been able to go and I was going to go, I would have been more than willing, because I think that we get, I mean, the amount we get as city council members every month, I mean, I would.
That's your opinion, Sarah, and I respect that, but my opinion, okay, put it, okay, prior to here, what administration have never went to LMA meetings? I mean, what mayor?
You mean as a group?
Yeah, hell, well, I mean, I know you don't go because you choose not to go, but what mayor said, because I decided not to give you the money or present this money, you can't go. What other mayor did that?
But he had this one here this time.
Right, exactly, that's the only one he did, so that's a problem, and why everybody else not doing it? Why didn't the rest of the mayor not do it?
But then again, we should have, like you said, proactive, we should have looked at, we knew it was coming up.
I told Susan months ago, and she said, okay, yeah, that's what I'm saying, I told her months ago, and I said, make sure you get us in the hotel, what the activities are. I mean, that way you right there, you learn a thing, you have workshops there, you have, you meet and greet, you know, it's a lot of things go on there that helps the city, helps you as a council, probably things that you can learn to be a more efficient council person if you was there. That's what I'm saying. And I'm quite sure the chief, I mean, chief, do y'all have continuous education, anything going on when you go to those meetings?
I'm required to do at least every 3 months. I have to get 24 hours within a year for mine. The LMA, I also would get credit if I did that one. And if I'd have went, I would have got credit for being there.
That's all I'm saying.
When you asked months ago, or whatever, I wasn't aware of that, but months ago, I thought we would have a budget passed. But you know,
the budget was passed.
But you weren't even here to vote on it.
But the budget passed, it don't matter what I hear now, it's a council as a whole. Everybody don't be here at every meeting. I mean, it's just that simple, but that still don't accept the fact that you tried to dictate what we can do. That's what I have a problem.
Well, I didn't stop anybody from going that chose to go. It just wasn't based on the way that
we'll put ordinance in place, man.
And the way the budget had went, and we had that I'd had to lay off people and that kind of thing. I just didn't feel like that.
Yeah, you go again. You didn't feel like that. Go again. You didn't ask either.
And that would be a wise expenditure of the city's money.
But you
went in driving.
Okay, but you just laid out with 9 people and saved $266,774. I mean, that's how much savings you had in this last layoff.
Well,
so you trying to tell me now that if it costs us $100 room or $50 expenditure check, that's towing to that too much, huh?
Well, in my opinion, it was.
Your opinion again. That's what I'm talking about. That's what got to stop there. That your opinion. Ask somebody.
Well,
we all was elected. That's what I'm saying. All of us elected. You were just the only one elected. All of us was elected.
And the only reason that all that happened and the budget was done like that was there again because of the reluctance and the nobody or the council's certain members of the council not willing to pass rate increases.
Okay.
That's why I felt forced I had to do it, to try to keep us in line with what we have to pay in on the bonds.
So everything bonds.
I'm asking you a question. Back to the bond thing. We're going to save $300,000. You know, you got very few people even working for the city, so we're not even providing the city the service that they deserve. But we bought a truck and a couple other things that we purchased. And why are we needing all of this money? I'm gonna tell you why we need all this money there. Because when the bond thing was set up, not only this administration, the prior administration, neither one of y'all did what you were supposed to do to set up those bonds and make sure that the council stuff and the money was going in. That's the reason why we're in the situation we're in. And the whole city is suffering behind those steps. We can't get no streets, we can't get nothing done, period. Because all the money is going toward the bond. So like you said, I'll do whatever it takes to pay the bond. And we gave you other money, the 20%. But
it still, it's not in there magic overnight. It only comes in on a monthly basis. And it takes, you know, it's not like when we voted that food, it's all in there at one time. That comes in on a monthly basis.
I understand what you're saying, but this $300,000 or $400,000 being saved, where is it going?
It's not there again. That savings doesn't happen overnight. That's over a 12-month period, so it takes time.
It's been pretty much over. Since you've been making up all these people found out, it's been over like almost one of a 3 years. And we're not having the same obligation with people that are working for us in the city that we had before. But then still, we keep on talking about raising electric bills, raising all. We want to know where the money's going. We haven't bought anything but a truck. And a building over there, and I mean, that's it.
I will be glad for you to come by, and I'll give you an accounts payable listing of every check that's written every month. And I'll get you that for the month of July when Susie gets back. And you can see line item by line item where it's going. And it's all for legitimate expenses for the city of Winfield, I can assure you.
If we look at the budget that y'all voted in, I didn't know what to do, but I'm full of it. We got $5,000 in that budget to tear down houses, to cut grass, and it's no way in the West Word. We don't go for a whole year for $5,000. So we really need to go back and look at this whole budget to come up with a way to take this city forward for the next year. Because this budget y'all got out here y'all voted for, it's not going to do it.
So what you're saying is that when the health insurance for our employees goes up and all those costs go up, we're not going to take that money that we've used to mow grass and pay that. We're going to mow grass instead.
Well, it's not going to go up $300,000.
It's
not going to go up $300,000.
But it's going up enough, and other things go up too. I use that as an example.
Lay it on the table.
Everything, the gas price, fuel prices for all the vehicles go up. Things go up. Workers' comp is doubling.
We can have another budget meeting and try to go over all that.
But when all those things start to add up, and then if you don't have the money for them, what are you going to do? Mow grass instead? No, you're going to pay those things. Those things are the vital things we have to do.
We don't have enough employees right now to be a workers' comp.
You got to think about what you're saying. We don't have enough employees right now to even for the city even function. So now we're talking about workers' comp and insurance. We just lost four people, so that's going to be how much insurance a month? Another $4,000 or $5,000 that we don't have to deal with.
Right.
Okay. Well, so
you give an employee, you know what I'm talking about.
We have to try to keep what we got, staff back up where we can.
That's not a real good job, keep what we got, because we started losing people all the time. We just lost two more.
Well, that was unfortunate, but it happened.
But it happened. So how are you planning on taking the city forward? Just tell me that.
I'm taking the city forward on this budget one day and 1 month at a time as best I can. And if we need to amend the budget to make some adjustments, and the money is there, then we can do it. I'm trying to make sure that we fulfill these bond covenants and bond obligations, and because we're bound by those bond documents to do that.
So we're bound by
taking care of this city and this taxpayer's money by putting something back in the city and making it go. We also found out that the bonds are not the only thing that's sitting here that stands in the face.
No, and that's why I'm saying to do those other things, we need some increase in revenue. But without that, then I'll have to make the adjustments in other ways. So that's what I'm trying to do. Believe me, I don't enjoy not having enough people to really get the job done like we would like to see it done. But trying to do the best I have with the money that we have.
Can I ask you something? We had a meeting a couple of weeks ago and talked about an idea for increasing revenue. And you told me you didn't vote for it because you didn't think it was enough.
Well, it was enough. But you know that's a need because you agreed to that you would have done it if it had been more of an increase that you would have done. No, I'm just saying you're agreeing that we do need to increase revenue somewhere on top of the other. You said the same. We also lost these people. We lost eight people. We saved over $300,000. We got another $400,000 to $500,000 we're going through it in a minute. So what are you saying?
I was just asking why you would agree to do, increase the revenue if it was more, but you didn't want to increase it a little bit, knowing we needed it.
A little bit. Because a little bit's not going to help.
That's right. So I'm asking you, when he talks about wanting to do an increase, you say that that's not going to solve any problems.
That's what y'all wanted at the time. I didn't want it.
Okay, but what you said at the meeting the other day was because it wasn't enough. Okay, would you be willing to do something more until you take it on?
Well, I figured out when Lynn didn't tell me exactly what the money we just saved. Over $300,000. Tell me where that's going to go.
How's it going to help us? It's going to help us pay to catch up with all that bond payment. Can we pay that bond maybe?
What about the rest of the system?
Well, what about when electricity went off the other day? You were worried about that. That's one of those things. What did he say about our state-of-the-art substation? That looks good. Now we need the money to do the infrastructure that goes with it. But we don't have that money if we don't increase somewhere.
All I can say is that to lay it out here, it's not going to add up. What you did, you jumped up and voted for a budget that we really did not look into and see how much money we need and where we need to be. Now, we're sitting here saying, okay, we got to go back and raise some more money. Now we got to go back and raise electric bill. We got to go back and
say that in 2 years. 2 years. So this budget we just passed had nothing to do with that. We weren't trying.
We gave you the budget.
You guys don't even know what's in the budget. Like the rest, if you can give me two line items in the budget that you voted for, I will shut up.
I'll tell you one specifically.
I said two.
Okay, I'll start
with one. Well, I'm cool with that, girl. That's my item on the table.
I voted for the one for the rec department, that is $300,000, and I voted for the one for the police department, which is $1.5 million. Now, those are two things I did vote for in that.
Excuse me. Yep. Yeah, I want to discuss that. That's my item there.
All right. Number five is Animal Shelter by Mr. Hales.
Yeah, I want to talk about the Animal Shelter because I was trying to see, we took responsibility out of the shelter for the last, I don't know, year. And it was said on KNOE News that the council, three council voted to get rid of the Animal Shelter by Mayor Bell. And so my question is, first of all, which three councils voted to get rid of it?
That was a misquote by the news media.
Oh, okay, news media.
I learned over the years that they do get their stories messed up a little bit.
Oh, okay, that's what I wanted, because they said the council didn't pass his budget, and our finger was pointed at certain three that said that y'all didn't pass the budget, that's why this shelter is closing down.
But that's what was said. That's what I'm talking about.
There needs to be some clarity there. How three councils shut it down, but it don't belong to us. According to state law, the parish is supposed to be running the shelter, according to state law, not the city. So I'm trying to wonder, Ms. Junkin, did you ever get a chance to speak with the parish? Because we spoke with the parish and the Humane Society in regards to
what type of...
They was gonna go speak to
them.
So where did it come to that? I even got a phone call saying the council, y'all.
That's the reason that misunderstanding things and putting it on Facebook and people thinking this is what somebody, you know, the he said, she said stuff.
Okay, that's what I was, I just wanted some clarity. Mr. Newspaper Lady, we need to make sure we get some clarity that the council is doing this.
And I did pull some of the information that they had given me about the statutes and permits. It's under the agriculture section of the revised statutes.
Right.
And there's a whole bunch of things.
Yeah, but I know it's stated that the parish was the one supposed to be, they say shell provided, so not shell to the facility.
You know, the last three, not only us, but everybody else who were putting $45,000, $50,000, $60,000 into the animal shelter thing over the past 9, 10, 12 years, you allowed to do that illegally? Hold up. Before you get off in there, you better read the law. Because it's plain to tell us. But we don't do it. We have nothing to do with that. That comes down from the parish passed it back down there once, they passed it back to us, and we jumped all over. And we didn't make a budget. And then the reason why we didn't have a budget for this time, because we found out it was illegal. That's why we didn't have a budget for it.
Anyway, is that any more discussion?
No, that's all I wanted to know. Yeah, I just want to get that cleared up, because I mean, I heard those facts.
I just want the public to know that we have been budgeted for the last 3 or 4 years, of 9, 10 years. We weren't supposed to be in that tier. We went to the tier. The parish will take care of that, and we should work out something together. So we've been putting $45,000 every year.
All right, now. That's the last new business non-action item. Do I have a motion to adjourn by Ms. Demery? Do I have a second?
Second.
Who made the motion?
Let's make it. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Sarah, second.
I said.
Adjourn.
Y'all have to be.
Thank you.